we tell our story. Beneficiaries, stakeholders, protagonists of cohesion policy tell what we are doing and what can be done, what have been done. The benefits of cohesion policy from my point of view, well, I'm a young Italian girl, actually a young European, I would say. Cohesion policy gave me the chance to participate to this great initiative from Interreg. I could live abroad, I could boost my language skill, my professional skills, and gave me a job, basically.
It's a matter of studies and thorough evaluations which have shown that the investments provided through cohesion policy over the past 30 years have helped achieve convergence between the EU member states, have helped the poorer member states and regions develop, modernize, but have also helped the richer member states, the more developed ones, specialize, find their edge in the global economy.
I myself will encourage people to even further strengthen what we call a place-based approach of cohesion policy that helps to address the needs of the citizens of cities and regions at a very nuclear level and helping them to define and implement their own solutions addressing the challenges of the different places.
What we missed is really methods to communicate, to build a relation. The people who have now a job should speak out. Students who have their Erasmus can talk about it. And it is very often, and here with the CPMR in the coastal regions, you see that new technology is coming in to help us in the climate questions. You need some time to tell about the stories. And this is today's debate here. We need new methods to blog, to have the social media, or in fact to be ambassador and spend some money for that.
The drawback is of course related to the fact that maybe the results are not that visible at a pan-European scale, and maybe we should think about increasing the visibility of cohesion policy. This means that for the next programming period we should think about promoting what we call joint investment, engaging several places in joint investment activities, because this will then help to use the public resources that are available to us in a much more efficient way.
I think that in the debates with the citizens, we should take up where we can change our policy. So it's not just a top-down, but it's also a bottom-up. And next year's elections will be really important in that.